Good morning, student. Let us revise the topic goodwill and its various valuation method. And before coming to the point why the valuation of goodwill is important, let me throw some light. As we have already discussed accounting standard 26. This accounting standard 26 is very important accounting standard, and it is applicable in all the cases. That is admission of a partner, in case of retirement, in case of death and change in profit sharing ratio. So as we have already studied change in profit sharing ratio, I am just correlating this topic with the change in profit sharing ratio. As goodwill, there are two cases is given relating to goodwill, like purchase goodwill and non-purchase goodwill. So the concept should be very clear. What do you mean by purchase goodwill? It means that you have paid some money or money worth to acquire that asset. So then only it will be treated as an asset in the business. Otherwise, non-purchase goodwill means you have paid nothing to acquire that asset. It is just self-generated asset, so it will not be shown in the books of account, and its value is adjusted while involving partner's capital account. So then what should be the value of goodwill? So we will discuss, we have already discussed the various method, and in this video I will just revise once again the various methods that are used to calculate the value of goodwill. So you must be very thorough with this accounting standard 26. It is applicable. And now let us move, as you know well, the term goodwill. What do you mean by goodwill? That is good name, good reputation that leads to increase the value of the product more than the normal profit. So that is what, because of the good reputation of business in the eyes of customer. And what are the various method that used to calculate the value of goodwill? That is, as per the syllabus, we have to cover only three methods, that is average profit method, super profit method and capitalization method. So let us see various steps that are to be followed to calculate the value of goodwill. Once again, you just be thorough and follow the steps. And in under capitalization method, you can see there are two sub methods. One is capitalization of average profit method and capitalization of super profit method. So let's see first average profit method. What are the various steps that we are to follow to calculate or get the value of goodwill? Under this, you have to calculate first the average profit, that in question number of years goodwill is given. You just sum all the good profit and divide it by number of years. So you will just get the average profit. See here, first step is calculate normal profit or loss. As we have discussed, if suppose during the year there is any abnormal losses occurred, what adjustment you have to do? You just add it back to the respective year's profit. That profit you will consider while calculating the average profit. And other abnormalities, like if any capital gain is added to the normal profit, so it is very important to first deduct that capital gain or capital loss, whatever, and then you get the actual normal profit, and then you do all add the all the year's profit, and then you in the third step you just calculate it by dividing it by number of years given in the question. Then you will get the average profit. And in the step 4, goodwill value, how you will get that average profit is multiplied by number of year purchase. Once again, I am repeating, number of year purchase refers to the expected situation that is going to continue for coming 2 or 3 years, whatever the case, whatever the year specified in the question. It is expected that this situation is remain constant in coming 2 or 3 years. So you just, while multiplying number of year purchase with average profit, you will get the value of goodwill. So in case when we will discuss death of a partner, or when we will, as we have already discussed, change in profit sharing ratio, goodwill value is to be calculated. So if it is asked to calculate by average profit method, then you follow these 4 steps. First, you just calculate the normal profit. Second step is sum all the number of years profit, then divide. Third step, you just divide it by number of years. You will get your average profit. And step 4, average profit is multiplied by number of year purchase. This is one of the method, average profit method. Now come to the next method, super profit method. Super profit method, what steps and some of the important things you must be very clear to determine the value of goodwill under this method. First, actual profit, that is average profit. What we have learned in average profit method to get the average profit, you just do adjustment of any abnormalities or any capital gain, that you just add and deduct, get the actual profit. And normal rate of return here refers to, as every businessman expects certain rate of return from business. So if suppose capital, then you have to find out the capital employed into the business. Capital employed here refers to the capital introduced into the business. So let us see how this average profit that we have already discussed, how to calculate, and normal rate of return. Of course, normal rate of return is generally expected return from the business, and it may differ industry to industry. Some business having more rate of return, in some other business less rate of return. Whatever that will be given in your question, what is the expected rate of return. And capital employed is to be calculated, and this term not only is used here in part B also, when we will discuss return on capital, how you will calculate the capital employed. There are 2 approaches, liability side approach. If liability side information is given, then you will calculate capital employed, and with the help of asset side approach also you can calculate the capital employed. See, I am just showing it by this balance sheet. As you know, what liabilities are for the partnership firm, like partners' capital, reserves, and external liability. If suppose this 3 information is given, partners' capital, reserves, and external liability, then how you will get your capital employed? Partners' capital plus reserve, you just add it and deduct non-trade investment. Or see, in the asset side, fictitious asset is given, so it must be deducted. Means asset side, non-trade investment and fictitious asset is deducted, and capital, partners capital and reserve is added, you will get your capital employed value. And if suppose from the asset side you want to calculate, then what you have to do, add fixed asset with the current asset and deduct the external liability. That also can give you the capital employed. So this formula is very important, how to calculate the capital employed. If with the help of balance sheet, if you want to calculate, then you can apply this formula. And if simply 2 partners are there in a firm and each partner's capital is given, you just add the capital of both the partner. That is also you, that also you will get your capital employed. Nothing reserve is not given, only capital is given. So this is the way how you will calculate the capital employed, है ना. Now, what are the steps that are to be followed to calculate the value of goodwill by super profit method? First, you calculate the average capital employed. So again, average capital employed simply no need actually. Simply, if average profit is given in the question, then first step is not required. Generally, in question, average profit is given. And if it is not given, you can calculate. Or if capital employed is also given, you just add the capital of both the partners. See here step average, if it is asked to calculate average capital employed also, then what formula you will apply? Opening capital employed plus closing capital employed divided it by time. But this is not in your syllabus. Your question will start from average profit. If it is not given, you just calculate average profit. Second step, calculate normal profit. In case of normal profit, you just take capital employed figure, and normal rate is also mentioned in the question, normal rate by 100. So you will get your normal profit. And in the third step, you just calculate the adjusted average profit. And actually it is not a third step. Simply you just do one thing, average minus normal will give you the super profit. And then at the step 5, super profit, again you just multiply it by number of year purchase, you will get your value of goodwill. So altogether you have to follow mainly 4 step. Step 1, average profit if it is required to be calculated. Second, you just calculate your normal profit with the help of capital employed and apply the normal rate that is given. Third step, super profit, that is average profit, or you can say actual profit minus normal profit. That difference is called as super profit. And in the next step, super profit into number of year purchase. Now come to the next method, capitalization method. As I already said, under this we have 2 methods, capitalization of average profit method and capitalization of super profit method. Under how to calculate capitalized value of average profit, that you have to be very careful. Capitalized value of average profit, what average profit, if it is given in the question, multiplied by 100. You just reverse the normal rate as a denominator and numerator 100. Average profit into 100 by normal rate of return. That will give you the capitalized value of average profit. And then to earn this normal rate of return, what capital it is expected to be introduced and what actually introduced, that we have already discussed. The capital employed means all the assets minus outside liability, that is already given in the question to calculate. So net assets method, you just get the value of what amount you have introduced into the business. This is what actually you have invested, and this capitalized value is what should be introduced to invested to get this normal return. And then what you have to do, then you will get your goodwill value, that capitalized value that you have calculated in first step, deducted by net asset, that is what actually the capital introduced. That difference is treated as goodwill. So I'm just recalling you, first you have to capitalize the average profit. How you will capitalize? That is average profit into 100 by rate, normal rate that is given in the question. Second step, you just calculate what net asset, that what capital you have actually introduced. And in the third step, you will get the goodwill capitalized value. You just take it, and net asset in the second step, what you have calculated, that difference is treated as goodwill. This is what the method capitalization of average profit. Now come to the next step, next method. That is capitalization of super profit method. So under capitalization of super profit method, first of all, you just calculate the capital employed, the same what you have calculated in the previous method. Now again you calculate the normal profit that we have already discussed when we were calculating the goodwill by super profit method, how to calculate the super profit. The same way you just find out the normal profit, and then next is average profit. If it is given, if not given, you just calculate it, super profit that you know well, average profit minus normal profit. And in the fifth step, you just capitalize the super profit. The same way how you have capitalized the average profit, here you will capitalize what? Super profit. That is super profit into 100 by rate. You just remember this capitalization method. So this is, this will give you the value of goodwill. So these all are the various methods we have already discussed. Once again, I just give you, I just revise all the various method about the accounting standard 26. This topic is important for coming all the coming up chapters, admission, retirement, death, and even in change in profit sharing ratio. You have already seen, without calculating value of goodwill, you cannot do any adjustment. So this is all about non-purchase goodwill, because we have not purchased this asset, that is a self-generated. So how you will see here, this line, you just be clear with this topic here. If goodwill is evaluated at the time of change in the constitution of firm, whatever may be the case, reconstitution takes place due to admission, retirement, death or change in profit sharing ratio, goodwill would not be brought in the book, because it is the self-generated, and we have to evaluate the goodwill. And for this, we need these methods, that is average profit method, super profit method, capitalization method, that is capitalization of average profit, capitalization of super profit. So this is what the concept of goodwill. This is all about this topic. I revise, you just go through the topic thoroughly and solve all the questions. Thank you so much.